6 years after construction began on the Ohio and Erie Canal, the Monticello was the first boat to arrive in Coshocton in 1831. Today you can ride the Monticello III on a 1.5 mile restored section of the original canal path. The construction of canals in Ohio nearly bankrupted the state government, but they allowed Ohioans to prosper from 1830 to the start of the Civil War. That's because the cost to ship goods dropped from $125 per ton when traveling over land to only $25 per ton by using the canals. On the Monticello III, the captain will share many stories about the Ohio and Erie Canal, the workers, and the passengers.
We became the number one agriculture state. Our population about almost tripled in 30 years. The canals had a lot to do with it. Land prices in more than 30 counties went up. But the state really was doing well. But the railroad.
While canal boats were usually pulled by mules, the Monticello III uses horses, which are led by a person called a hoagie. The captain explained that horses will overwork themselves even to the point of death, while mules know when to quit. The pilot is responsible for steering the canal boat over the water, which by original design is 4 feet deep and 40 feet wide. The ride is smooth and quiet. The Ohio and Erie Canal played an important role in Ohio's history. It turned our struggling frontier state into one of the richest states in the country. But as railroads became the preferred method of transporting goods, the canals declined in use and value. After the Great Flood of 1913, the Ohio and Erie was mostly destroyed and later abandoned. We're fortunate today to have this section of the canal fully restored. So while you're traveling around Ohio, make sure you step back into time and take a ride on the Monticello III.